guys, welcome back to pretty much Project Wohnwagen with Franken Turbo F23 kit. Engine is out of the car, and we degreased the transmission just barely. So now we're removing the intake manifold, fuel rail, the turbo, and the discharge pipe for tonight, just to give you guys a showing. To remove the intake manifold and fuel rail, you're going to need a 10mm socket for the fuel rail. And then for the intake manifold, you will be needing a socket with an Allen tip right here. We're using, what size are we using here? Pretty much a 5. It's going to be a 5 for an Allen tip right here. They will be quite a few, but you need to remove the fuel rail first before the intake manifold can come out. So there's two bolts that holds it down, and it pulls straight out. So pull it straight out. The injectors will come with it. As you can see, all four injectors come out with the fuel rail. Pretty much just be careful. Pull the vacuum line if you haven't taken it off. Right below. Right here. Pull that vacuum line out. Just yank on it. Doesn't matter. We're redoing the entire engine, guys. And fuel rail will come off.
What about these?
There's a couple other lines attached to it. There should be water lines. So leave those alone. But the fuel rail will come off with it. Here's the fuel rail. That is off the 1.8T engine. Next up is the manifold. Once you take the fuel off, you'll see all the bolts exposed. Using the 5mm Allen socket, just take off all those and the manifold will pop right off. All right, guys. On some of the 1.8T engines, there will be another bolt here, right here, that hold the manifold in place. This one doesn't have it because it's already been taken off, so you can take, I can unscrew it. All right, that will be the first part. The next part will be taking the turbo off, and we'll show you guys that in a couple minutes. All right, everybody, so the intake manifold's out. As you can see right here, pretty straightforward, like I was telling you guys. It's not very difficult to remove once the engine is out. So the next part of the job is removing all this cluster F that's on this side of the engine. You'll see, this is the back of the engine, so you'll see the turbo inlet pipe. This right here will be the discharge pipe. The heater hoses, we're going to leave alone. We're not going to move those. This right here is the actual turbo, right here, going left to right. The manifold, which is attached to it, which will be the last thing we'll be taking off on this. So first things first, same, using the same Allen bit that we're using for the manifold, we're going to remove the discharge pipe with that. There's two bolts there. This one was missing the other two on top, so yay for us. A little bit less to remove. And like before in the previous episodes or videos, we are using sandwich bags to store everything. So, sandwich bag and a Sharpie. Bam. And we're going to write on it what it's for once we get everything off. The discharge pipe pretty much is only two sets of bolts. Two here, two up here. And then one clamp right here at the bottom by the turbo. We're going to use a flathead screwdriver to remove it. Once that's off, the discharge pipe will come right off. All right, guys. Discharge pipe is removed. The next thing is the hoses. There's one right here on the wastegate actuator. You'll see this right here. That one, just yank it off. There's nothing special. And if I can't yank it off, we'll have my buddy here yank it while I hold the engine. It's coming. If not, we'll cut it off. There's enough slack on this hose that you don't need to worry about buying another one. The hose itself is actually pretty dang long, so we don't need to worry about how much slack is on it. So we got the discharge pipe removed completely. Next thing will be the turbo inlet pipe. We got to remove that bad boy. And that one's also held together with the Phillips clamp down here. As you can see, right here at the bottom. Get that bad boy unclamped. And just remember, everybody, this is all being done with two guys, full-time jobs, on our days off, so or whatever time we have spare. So we want people to understand that this can be done pretty quickly as long as we take our time and do things right. Turbo inlet pipe is now removed. And the hose is removed for it. As you can see, turbo is now exposed. You'll notice a lot of these components have a lot of oil. Turbos naturally actually leak oil. Not a ton, but very little. And they also will receive a lot of oil from the crankcase setup. The breather setup up here on these engines do put a lot of oil back into the turbo, so you're going to see that as well. It's not a thing to be afraid of. It's actually normal for turbos. So the next thing we're going to do is actually start removing the actual turbo off of here and the oil and water lines. On here, the turbo has three bolts on top that hold it together. And then you're going to have quite a few bolts that hold the lines together. You're going to want to remove this first, which is the heat shield. It's going to be a larger socket. Where do we put our sockets? Right here. I believe it's going to be this bad boy. Nope. That one. Let me see. And this is a 6mm Allen bit. Just so everybody knows, we're going to be using a 6mm to take off the heat shield on this guy. It's held together by quite a few bolts. There's one, two, looks like two for this one. After that is removed, the next one we're going to go to is actually the turbo manifold on the very top, and that's held together by three 17mm bolts on top. So I'll grab that for him. So we broke loose the manifold bolts right here. So these guys are pretty much ready to come off. Kind of. As you can see, these guys can come off with no problems now. Except for this one. Here, break that one loose. There we go. My buddy here, Hercules, can do this. So we got these three off. Nice and loose. The next thing is to get the main lines off the turbo now. There's two water lines and two oil lines. This one right here. You'll see that's the water line right there. He's taking off the water feed line. The one right below is the water return line. While taking that off, it will remove the rest of the bracket here for the discharge pipe. This will make a mess, just so you know, so try to put a rag on the ground because it will spill water. When you take the feed line out, the return line, not the feed line. Most of it should have been drained through removing the engine pretty much. Once you get that line, that assembly loose, don't worry about it. Get the next line out, which is right here, the return line right here at the bottom. Uses the same socket to remove it. And this is the one that's going to make a mess. No, you got to go all the way in. You're going to strip it. Right there. There you go. There's the mess. You see that coolant just spilling right there? Let it, just let it drip slowly until it drips all the way out. It'll take a minute. It's got a decent amount of coolant in there still. This is what's inside the block. If it doesn't finish, get a cup to catch it. So we have removed the return line, or the feed line, you want to call it, for the coolant. And we got a bee in the light. And now we also have this line loose as well, which is the water feed line. Now the next one we're going to remove is the actual oil feed line, which comes at the front of the engine. And you'll see it right here. It's right by your oil filter tap. There's a couple ways of removing it. Try to get stuff out of the way. That pulls right out. Sometimes. If not, you can bend it. You can always bend it back. So. And there's that feed line. Be careful. Before you take the line out, just get a rag to make sure there's no oil that drips out of it. Usually the feed line won't have any oil in it because this is the feed line. So a lot of the oil will be already gone because it feeds it back into the engine. No, don't pull on that. You still have a 12 mil right here that holds the line in place. Okay, these lines will not be used anymore for the F23 turbo kit that we're using. We got custom lines made for it. So these will be no longer used in your build, guys. It does come with the turbo kit. You will be using the hardware or the banjo bolts that come with it, though. So make sure you don't lose them or misplace the bolts that you need to do this. All right, guys. So we removed most of the turbo. There's a couple things you got to pay attention to. There's a little bolt here that you're going to need an Allen wrench to remove it with. Once you get that one removed, you're going to need to remove the oil line right here. There's two bolts on top to hold the oil line in place. You'll see right here. One, two, same size Allen wrench you're going to use to remove this. There's also two bolts here that require an Allen wrench as well to remove these two. And this is the turbo mount bracket right here, as you can see right up here. This holds the turbo in place. So it doesn't vibrate like crazy when you're driving it. And then we just removed the three bolts on top on the manifold to actually hold it. And two more left right here on the top. This one is the water feed line, and then this one is the oil feed line to the turbo. The two underneath are pretty much the return lines. So we're going to be using another Allen bolt. What size is this bad boy? This is a number 8 for this guy. That fell on the ground. And goes in there pretty straightforward. I have someone hold the turbo for you, because it will move. Alright guys, so we broke them loose. Pretty much we're just removing the lines. And remember, these are the feed lines. These are the water feed and oil feed. Remember which ones they are and what order they go in, because they're very important when you mount the new turbo. They use the same factory locations, but just with newer lines. So we got to remember this, okay, guys? This is very important to installing the new turbo. Hold on, before we get it out, there are copper crush washers you're going to require as well. These bad boys. All of them are the same size for the feed lines and the return lines for the turbo itself. So go buy a set. I highly recommend ECS Tuning or the dealer. They're fairly inexpensive, and you need two per line and per end. All right, guys. Turbo's off. You got the little itty-bitty turbo right there, the KO3S. still makes a lot of power for such a tiny little turbo. And you gotta keep in mind, it's a small 1.8 liter engine, so no, it doesn't make a lot of power. But tuned properly with the proper bolt-ons, you make a decent amount of power, guys. So the next part of the job, guys, is removing the exhaust manifold. You're gonna be using a 12 millimeter socket with an extension. It's very, very straightforward, just like removing the intake manifold. Just remove all the bolts. They have a nut and a washer. If you're planning on reusing these, take your time removing them. You can pull the studs out with them if you don't take your time and just break them loose slowly. Once they're all removed, the manifold will pop right out. It slides right off, guys. Okay? Thank you. So now that we have the intake manifold removed, as you can see, our pile of stuff here on the ground, discharge pipe, turbo, turbo inlet pipe, heat shield, all the vacuum lines in a manifold, a couple oil, the water line right here as well. Here is the turbo, I mean the exhaust side of the engine. You can see the valves right there, look pretty lean. So we might have to do like a good cleaning on this this side of the engine. Clean that these valves out. And that way we can get this engine running nice, very nice. And I'll have a DIY for that later, guys. So the next thing, part of this engine is removing the side right here. Right here you have a combi valve. This is part of smog equipment. And you have your water flange here for your heaters, for your cooling system. We're gonna have to remove the heater hose right here first. So we took off the clamp. As you can see, there's a clamp right here. Pinch it off, pull the hose off. Eventually, careful not to rip it. There we go. And then this will reveal the three bolts here for the combi valve. There's three Allen bits. One, two, three down below. Take those three off and it will remove the rest of your smog and vacuum lines off this car. I will have a DIY of making the block off plate to save you guys a bit of money. A block off plate made by Integrated Engineering or 42 Draft Designs, it's like 20, 30 bucks. We can make one for about $4 to $5 and it works just the same. Not gonna look as pretty, but it worked just the same. All right, guys, so the combi valve and the coolant flange has been removed right here. We just started removing the radiator hoses. They're pretty straightforward. Just take the clamps off, pull the hose off, and yank. Just take your time. Don't break them. Don't try to bend them or anything like that. Just pry on them slowly. They will come off. So we're taking all the upper radiator hoses, the oil cooling lines. Leave the main hard line alone. The moment this hose wiggles a little bit, it will start leaking coolant when you put it all back together. And a leaky coolant line, let me show you where this line goes into. Let's see if I can see it. Here you go. Yeah, there's an O-ring that sits right here, and you do not want that to leak. It's not fun to repair. It's really hard to get to. So leave it alone if you're going to take it out. If you do take it out, go buy a new O-ring at the dealer. And that's pretty much it. You guys will see us back in a couple of days because we do have to work. But this is what it looks like. Almost completely disassembled. Pretty soon you're going to see it with the turbo on here. All clean. We're going to start degreasing it pretty soon. And this baby's going to look super good once we're done with it. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. And you will be seeing more of Project Wahoonwagen. pretty much a Franken Turbo F23 Turbo Kit using Motoza Performance Tuner. Hope to see you guys soon. Bye.